This is CNN Breaking News.
We have major breaking economic news, surprising breaking economic news, confusing breaking economic news. The January jobs report is in, and it's way better than people were expecting. CNN Chief Business Correspondent and anchor of Early Star, Christine Roman, is here with the numbers. Roman.
Yeah, not at all what we were expecting, because Omicron really ravaged the economy during January, but instead 467,000 net new jobs added back into the economy in January. That is the most jobs gained since August 2021. This is not the weak jobs figures that so many people had thought. Let me tell you why they were bracing for something terrible. It's because the survey from the government happened the very week some 12 million people were out sick or taking care of someone else who was out sick because of Omicron. So we were really looking for that distortion and didn't get it. I think what you can say here is there is surprising strength among employers who are hungry to hire workers, weathering even the Omicron variant here. 4% was the unemployment rate, a little change. And you saw pretty much broad-based gains in job creation, including leisure and hospitality, professional services, and trade. So we're watching these numbers digging in. There's going to be some what we call benchmark revisions. But overall, you put together the first 12 months of this Biden presidency, and it looks like it's the best job creation on record since we started counting those numbers from the Great Depression, John.
All right. Romans, you're going to come over and join us. And also part of this discussion now, CNN economics commentator and Washington Post opinion columnist Catherine Rampell and MarketWatch markets editor Mark DeCambra. Catherine, this is just not what people were expecting. The White House had been out earlier in the week bracing people for the possibility of jobs losses.
Right. Because it looked like the Omicron effect was going to overwhelm anything else in the economy. The Omicron effect being that there were a lot of workers who were out sick or who were caring for family members who were out sick. As Christine mentioned, during the week that this survey was conducted, something like 5 million new cases were detected. Of course, those people might still have been counted as employed if they were getting sick leave, et cetera. So it's really hard to know how to parse this report. It does look like whatever the Omicron effect was, it may have been overwhelmed by some seasonal adjustment weirdness, the fact that a lot of businesses are seeing more demand for their services, and so they're trying to hire workers. I'm going to have to dig into it a little bit more to figure out exactly how we got this fantastic number. I hope it's for good reasons and not just sort of like weird statistical noise.
To be completely blunt, you know, I prepare for this because economics isn't my first or second language here, and zero of my preparation had me ready for this type of job gain. Really? Mark, does this mean that the economy is saying to Omicron,
I mean, I think this is a surprising number, just as you guys said. We saw the ADP, the private sector report, that showed 301,000 losses for January. So this really led the stage for what we thought would be disappointing numbers. But I don't know that the economy is back, but it just kind of goes to show how very puzzling this whole economic recovery and economic cycle is in this COVID-19 phase.
I will say, look, people need to know that data has been impossible to read
Yes.
for 2 years now. The pandemic has made economic data very difficult. So you just have to sort of take it as it comes in, and then, you know, you revise it later on. But Romans, if these numbers are anywhere near right, what does it tell us about the overall strength of the economy?
It tells us exactly what the Fed Chief Jay Powell's been saying, that the job market is tremendously strong. And there are a bunch of revisions. And just to be clear, revisions over the year. So we've got to dig into those. But overall, what you hear from employers is we can't find the workers. And what you see in the numbers is people, it's not necessarily the great resignation anymore, but I heard this yesterday, the great upgrade. People are upgrading their jobs. They're quitting the job they have for better job, better pay. So I think the story in the American job market, it isn't layoffs or this month is weak. It is about a huge churn like we've never seen in the jobs market before. Wages in this report up 5.7% year over year. That's a really important number,
well,
I think.
We'll need to see what happens to inflation, right?
Yes.
I mean, what's the story of the past year has been we have seen these strong nominal wage gains, but they've been mostly eaten up by inflation. So take that with a grain of salt.
Yeah, the wage number was really the most important number. In fact, the market and really many economists were ready to dismiss this January report wholesale, with the exception of that wage number because of the impact of inflation. And we're seeing inflation pick up, but perhaps wages pick up, and certainly we're seeing that from the employment cost index also showed a big slowdown, but increase overall. And I think there's some questions about whether or not inflation is going up faster than wages, and that seems to be clearly the case.
Romans, sectors? I had seen as it came out, leisure?
That surprised me too, leisure and hospitality. I thought you would have lost jobs there, but you had gains in leisure and hospitality. You had gains in professional services, which I think we've seen all year. There was an amazing story in the Wall Street Journal this week about headhunters who are going after teachers who want to quit and retire, and they're putting them in sales, marketing, IT, all these professional and business services jobs. There's been huge demand there.
So Catherine, again, humor me for a moment with the notion that these numbers are not going to change wildly and revise and are an accurate reading of where the economy is. If we're adding jobs in leisure now, and this hospitality as well,
yep.
I mean, does this show that the economy is beginning to move beyond the pandemic? If people are going out to eat, if people are staying in hotels, if people are going on vacations, which again, the data today shows it's trending in that direction. What's the implication going forward?
That would certainly be good news for the economy. Leisure and hospitality was one of the most pandemic-sensitive sectors for exactly the reasons that you imply, that it's higher risk to go out to eat, to travel, et cetera, than to stay at home and, you know, click buttons and have things delivered to you, essentially. So those sectors had suffered among the biggest job gains throughout the economy, if in fact, and they have been adding back jobs, but they're still well below their levels pre-pandemic. But if in fact we did see a big boost in leisure and hospitality, again, it's hard to parse a little bit because there's some like usual seasonal patterns that they correct for, and the seasonal patterons may not hold.
January's a really tough month.
Yes, it's a weird month. So I don't want to put like all of my eggs in that basket, that like the number is good and so therefore that industry is healthy. It could be some other weird stuff, but it would be a good sign, of course, if leisure and hospitality are adding back jobs. And I think what we're seeing in general is that we've had several new variants, right, for COVID, and each time a lot more people have gotten sick, obviously, but there's been a smaller impact in terms of the actual economic effects. And maybe that's good and maybe that's bad. Maybe it means we're adapting. Maybe it means that people are being put in more vulnerable positions. I don't know. But it does seem that each time we get a new wave of this pandemic and people are anticipating a big hit to employment, it's more muted than expected.
I mean, the trend seems good, but I think the jury's still out. January, as you said, is historically a tough month to read. And if we had gotten a losing number, a negative number, we'd have dismissed that.
Right.
And maybe to some extent we should fade this one too,
yeah,
until we get more clarity into February and March. But the trend looks okay. There's a lot of data, a lot of further data to parse.
Let me ask you this a different way. What would an economy getting over the pandemic look like?
Well, I mean, I think we'd need to look into the numbers a little bit more, but, you know, some areas of, you know, I don't know what the labor force participation number came in as, because
a little changed. Said,
yeah, so that's one of the big areas that's problematic. Labor force participation was around 63%, over 63% before the pandemic, and it's still around 61 or so, 61.9 if it's unchanged. Then that means, you know, you don't have that full throttle economy because more people are out of the economy than in it pre-pandemic.
The summer was revised down a bit. We thought the summer was real big and strong. There's some downward revisions in the summer, which I think is important to note. And I also think there's this disconnect with how people feel and what all the numbers taken together show about the economy. We've talked about that a lot. People feel really cruddy about the economy. Right. The Fed doesn't. The Fed knows the economy is recovering. The inflation is running too hot. The Fed's going to start raising interest rates in a strong economy. So there's really kind of two sides to this story here, how people say they feel about it and what we see in these numbers.